Oh man, I was gonna let one more song play and then it was this. Oh, okay. Okay, okay, this song's gonna play and then we'll start, okay, guys? Oh, skip for real? You guys are trolling. Okay, all right. Skip. Okay, I'm gonna undeafen. Hey guys, welcome to the Hippo Cup 5 Mappool Showcase group stage. I'm your host, Digital Hypno. Joining me today is Mushimon and
hello
Vertarix.
Good morning, Osu players.
Good evening, Osu players.
So let's get started, guys. No further ado. This song. Yay. Okay, let's go. So the first map is none other than this absolute classic. Cookie Z on the leaderboard. Oh man. So here we see a very interesting mechanic with this tournament, and you might be wondering, why is it hidden? Isn't this Nomad 1? And you would be right, this is the first map of the map pool. Now, if you guys don't know, the very special rule in this tournament is that for every map, half of the players need to also take hidden, and then half the players need to not take hidden. So this is what the map is going to look like for half the people that go in. So, hopefully there's no confusion about, can all four players go hidden or like only one player? You're all in general voice, can you commentate?
Yeah, I think that's a really interesting point because teams usually bring on 2 to 3 hidden players in a normal 4v4 tournament just to fill their hidden slots to support their out on players. And now they really get to shine in all the free mod, no mod picks, and it'll be great to see.
Oh yes, for sure.
Something else that I think you need to keep in mind while like going into looking at these maps is that this is a score v1 tournament, which means that it is pretty much all up to combo. The only time that accuracy is going to be even remotely relevant is if everybody's FCing. And the thing is, like with a map pool like this for group stage, I think you can expect in a lot of these maps for everybody to be FCing pretty comfortably, just given like we're seeing a lot of cracked players in the roster, so it could come down to an at game, even given score v1.
Agreed. Thank you very much for the insight. There's a lot of very interesting rules about this tournament, and it's really designed to reminisce on the rule sets of tournaments from back in 2016. Oh, someone said this map sucks. Okay, guys, I think we're gonna have to be changing this pick.
I just received news that we'll be replacing this with Sky Flames, Kimitayo Hand in Hand by Aqua.
Oh, awesome.
Wow. Yeah. Apologies for the for misleading all of you.
Oh, this does look like a fairly tricky map for a Nomad 1.
Oh, yes. So
a lot more focused on bursts, it looks like, than like aim consistency.
Right, that's a good point. So the general structure for the Nomad 1s in this tournament is it's going to be more like control based rather than just like raw aim. The raw aim pick is going to be in Hard Rock. So Hard Rock 1 is really going to be the most generic type of aim. So this map, you can see there's actually some like 6-note bursts or like just in general kind of anti-aim awkward rhythms or angles and things like that.
Yeah, this map looks pretty strict. Just in terms of how much you have to control both of your tapping and your aim at the same time. And of course, if you have hidden added onto it, that can add an extra reading element as well.
Yeah, I really like that, since with Hard Rock, you'll get the smaller circles with a higher focus on precision. And with the, you know, your normal CS4s and whatnot in no mod, you know, you get a lot of room for, you know, getting more variety in aim.
All right, friends.
I think it's clear from the get-go that, you know, whoever was pooling this is picking bangers only.
Oh, for sure. Definitely. I really agree. I think the map pooler did a really good job with the song choice so far.
Yeah, now, they must have a really massive brain that critics might not be able to comprehend.
All right, so here we have the second map of the map pool. This is the second Nomad. Wow.
Now, this was actually in Hippo Cup 4, wasn't it?
Now, you see, this map has a lot of legacy.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it's really been in a lot of tournaments, and it's stood the test of time when it comes to song choice. And I think it's really just one of the map pool picks of all time that we are seeing here again in Hippo Cup 5.
True. This is one of the picks of all time. It is in 3-4, one of the best time meters.
This is a really fun map to play if you can actually wind up executing those very consistent streams. I know later in the map, the streams just get really long, so...
Oh, yes. It's going to be a real test, especially for the hidden players. I think you miss one note and it's just kind of doomed, so we're really going to have to see how things go during the matches.
Right, and what's the approach rate for this map?
Oh, that is a great question. You know, approach rate really just comes down to interpretation of the individual. It's the AR 9.2. I was checking.
Excellent stall, masterful use of speech.
Yeah, I can definitely see these streams being very difficult to read. I mean, even with no mod, while you can see all the notes in front of you, but especially with hidden, because you just have to with the variance and the aim for these streams, very easy to miss on.
My fellow non-hidden players, I say as a hidden player that if you note lock on hidden, you're lost, you're gone forever. You don't see the note lock. You have no idea how to get back on the stream, so be very careful with your aim, hidden players.
Yeah, I mean, it's really just a matter of GLHF, if you know what I'm talking about.
Right.
It's a 50-50. I see the map or you don't.
Right. It's like, I really do think that it's just kind of have to come down to, like, who's playing better, you know? Like, who's better? What's the overall difficulty? I think it's a little harder. I think... I mean... That is so funny.
What's your the overall difficulty is round of group stage. What's the difficulty of the pool? Oh, sorry, I'm so sorry.
So I think Headstack definitely has a lot of insight when it comes into map pool difficulty for Hippo Cup. This is overall pretty difficult. Oh, the below the stream is still Hippo Cup 4. Well, you see, you know, we're still in the process of updating. You know, we don't have the technology. It's really been a struggle to get things set up and running, you know?
All jokes aside, this looks like a pick that, you know, can really trip up people, even if they feel comfortable with the map itself, like playing in the tournament. I think nerf control as well, if you wind up getting nervous in a map like this, that can really affect your performance quite a bit.
Oh, yes, agreed. I think the spirals, like in the stream, because it goes like...
Mm-hmm. Wait, I missed that. How did it go?
It goes like...
Oh, you know, so like, right. Like remember that Reddit post where it's like lowercase a, small stack streams, uppercase a, very space streams? In this case, we're doing that with pitch, right? High pitch. Space,
right,
pitch.
Right, exactly. Now, so that's actually a very, very apt comparison. And that brings us to the end of Nomad 2.
It's a banger of a Nomad 2.
Yeah, absolute pick.
Thanks for sharing, Habib.
Excellent.
Now, here we have a special guest joining us for the Mappool Showcase. This is none other than, that's right, Fiery Rage for Nomad 3.
Now, I'm so happy he could get this score for us in Hippo Cup.
Very, very nice of him to do this on such short notice. Got a double S on this map. Just for Hippo Cup. Thank you so much, Fiery. And now here we can see true mouse cursor control coming into action here. Twice in a row. That's genius. Make a custom map of the same map just repeated twice, and that's the tiebreaker. Okay, that's way too smart. We just have the Lonely Goat challenge like looped. I shouldn't be saying this out loud. Let me get to my pool channel.
Write that down.
This looks like a pretty tricky map to aim from what I see.
Oh yeah, this map, I think like the spacing, like not being as consistent as you might expect. Like, I suspect a lot of people will under-aim some of these angles, just because...
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Yeah. Like, just not be able to snap as precisely as needed for some of these jumps.
Right. Like, the spacing is not as uniform as you might expect it to be.
Mm-hmm. And I expect a lot of the players to feel comfortable, like, sight-reading a lot of these maps. So I think they might surprise themselves how they can manage to perform if they're sight reading and not actually know what to expect in this map.
Well, I do remember playing this in tournaments in 2017 and 2018. And if you're on sight read, the AR will definitely catch you off guard. Unless, you know, it's a little subjective to you and you're really fine with it.
Mm-hmm.
Right, there's definitely some people who interpret approach rate much differently. And I think that really makes a big difference in reading the approach rate.
Apraxia.
Oh man, so true.
Yeah, I'm seeing that it's mostly an aim issue for this map. The tapping, from what I can see, looks fairly straightforward as long as you can, as long as you're comfortable enough with these alt patterns.
Right, I think the trickiest thing for maps like these is, like, at least tapping-wise, you sometimes end up, like, tapping before your cursor reaches the note, and then you'll end up, like, missing, even though you actually got your cursor on the note.
Right, not having the right synchronization.
Right.
Definitely. But you could even chalk that up to an aim issue as well.
That's true, almost. Like, not aiming fast enough.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But... I wouldn't be surprised to see some people trying to single tap a lot of this map, like Fiery Ritu.
Oh, yes, for sure.
But I think this map is definitely going to come down quite a bit to accuracy. I would expect a lot of our players to be able to FC this map fairly comfortably.
Right. There's a general rule of thumb, especially when it comes to Hippo Cup players, that they usually don't miss. Like, if you watch the matches, it's actually very interesting.
Right.
So, you know, some of these, like, replays, especially in the later stages of the tournament, you'll notice that the replay shows a couple misses here and there, but rest assured that Hippo Cup players definitely don't follow the same sort of rules. So,
Well, it's to be expected.
Right.
Yeah, more often than not, the replayers are not participating in Hippo Cup, so, you know, they might be prone to misses.
Right. Now, and see, this is definitely a prime example.
Oh, wow.
Here. We have one of the replays ever, and in it we can see...
And, wait, whose replay is this?
I'm not sure.
I didn't catch...
I must have missed it.
You know, the replays are submitted anonymously, so...
Oh, I see. Oh, that's interesting.
Anonymous. Yeah.
Okay, this is kind of a banger, though, I do have to admit.
Oh, yes. So this map was created by none other than Suki Nathan. Actually, he made the song and the circles.
It appears that this player played this map with Scorv2, and that's an interesting choice for reviewing their replay. Habib, do you have any?
I gotta go, guys.
This must have been a replay from Digitai Hypno, otherwise known as Dual Akira. You know, maybe he missed the memo that this was a Score V1 tournament. You know.
Well, regardless, it's the same map, so.
Oh yes.
It does look quite tricky, though.
Yeah, this map has some 1-6 quads. Look at that! But Hippo Cup players never miss.
Right.
Yeah, players have to be careful with some of these stacked patterns here. You know, maybe they might find themselves panicking and over tapping, you know, hitting a note way too early, or, you know, completely missing a note.
Or just completely misreading a whole section. I mean, that looks pretty doable here as well. Especially even with hidden too, depending on the player's comfortability with the mod.
Oh, Darren, and here we see our first Mappool showcase incident, where in the Mappool showcase, you might see a miss here or there, but, you know, like I said, rest assured, Hippo Cup players do not abide by the rules of Osu. What if you can put Scorby 2 for free mod? That's a good idea.
Yeah, that captures score at 1 million points. And, you know, that means when you're FCing, you're guaranteed a million points on the scoreboard. Valuable, big number for your team.
I think for a map like this, though, considering we can expect everybody to be FCing for the most part, I think a lot of this can come down to being able to execute those slider ends and follow through with all of these sliders accurately. Because if you drop a slider end, if everybody else is FCing with pretty high ACK, missing that slider end on your combo can get pretty detrimental on a map, especially of this length.
Right, that's actually a really good point. There's definitely some players in Osu that don't hit sirens. So,
hey.
Yo, so much. Sorry.
Right, so that's definitely a very good point. I definitely agree with your point.
Thanks.
Oh, cut stream.
Yeah, this map's got like a note or two that like you really gotta make sure you hit.
There's a couple circles.
Yeah, and that leads us to the next map, Nomad 5. Here we go. Now this map, you might
that's strange.
Now see, you might think.
I might think, therefore I might be.
What are we thinking about, Habib?
No, you see, that is, you know.
I'm already thinking too hard. I get it.
I think I've seen this map before. Might have been in an Osu map pool for United States tournament.
Right, so this tournament, It's actually very unique in that, like, the map pool format. So this map is 214 BPM. Is Nomad 5.
214. I can expect, yeah, no, I could expect this to be a fairly comfortable map as long as you can get in the groove. Like, once you get settled into the map, I think, you know, it does look tricky, but there's nothing that's really standing out to me as a very difficult part.
Yeah, true. It is one of those maps.
Oh, yes. For sure.
But, yeah, to go back to the format of this map pool.
Right.
This map pool is interesting because there's no hidden pool, right, Habib?
Oh, yes, that's correct.
We can expect half of the players at any given point to be playing hidden.
That's true. And half of the players to not be playing hidden.
Right. But that also means that to make up for the lack of a hidden pool, you need more maps in the pool, Habib.
Oh, yeah. That's actually a great point. So, you know, there's maps in the pool that, like...
True. There are maps in the pool.
So, the low AR map, for example... You might be very accustomed to a Mappool structure that has a low approach rate hidden, and then also maybe a gimmick Nomad map, right? And so in Hippo Cup, instead, we have both of those in the Nomad pool, and then half the players are going to be using hidden on them. So we have Nomad 6 that's going to be very rhythmically complex, and I think a lot of map pools rely on all players using Nomad on those maps to balance the difficulty. But in Hippo Cup, we still only use Nomad to balance the difficulty. It's just that two of the players are also going to have to use hidden. So it's really up to interpretation how difficult you find those maps to really be. But
bringing it back to this map, though, that seemed to be like a very consistent map, in my opinion. That seemed to be like, once you're comfortable with the map itself, that should be a pretty non-issue. It should just come down to ACK, and I would expect most people to be able to FC that fairly comfortably.
Oh, yes, right. Definitely agreed there. I think that's one of those maps where, you know, if you can play it, you can play it, right?
Right.
Yes.
Now here we have...
this is Nomad 6.
Yes, Nomad 6. Keen Observation, Mushimon. Here we have the 6th Nomad map. And it's got some rhythms for sure. It's got some stuff going on.
Mr. Hippo, do you happen to know the star rating of this map?
This map is a whopping 5.66 stars. Now, you might be very surprised to hear that it is such a high star rating. It is almost rounding up to 6 stars. But in fact, it only rounds up to 5.7.
Wow, I think Headstack would have something to say about the difficulty rating of this map.
You know, I'd expect this map to be pretty tricky, even from the get-go. I mean, there's a lot of these, like, aim control patterns that would be, for me, to be pretty tricky to hit, at least.
Oh, for sure.
Especially in a tournament setting, where you can be expecting everybody else to try to FC or else, you know?
Yes, there's definitely some one-third sort of, like, space streams. Or space bursts.
Yeah, accelerating, decelerating streams are going to catch a lot of people, and maybe a bunch of hidden players as well. Yeah. Teams might be relying on their Nomad players to carry through this one.
Now, the really exciting part about this map is that those one-third bursts, you can really just play as one-fourth and not really run into any issues. So, a bit of a life hack there for those of you who play in the tournament.
True, as a 41 tournament, combo is king.
Mm-hmm.
Now, wonderfully
yeah, as long
retarks.
As you can mash through, but like I said, like if everybody is FCing, then it comes down to an ACK game. But I think this is one of those maps where we might be able to see some, dare I say it, misses and slider breaks here.
Oh dear.
I mean, not that I would say that about any Hippo Cup players at all.
Oh yes, of course, right.
But more in theory, if a Hippo Cup player were to miss, I think this is a strong contender for a map that they might miss on.
Right, so here we have the 7th Nomad. Yes, that's right. There are 7 Nomads in this pool. And
you know, that's a lot of Nomads.
So here we have none other than Tana. Thank you very much for making this replay just for Hippo Cup. This is very,
yes,
very kind
you,
on such short notice. Thank you very much. And you see, this replay actually... So, the funny story... Tana actually is not really around anymore, but you know, I hit him up through Skype and I was like, hey, you wanna make a replay for Hippo Cup 5? And very, very kind. They kindly agreed, and still sticking with that mouse only gameplay. You can see really comfortable in these streams. But aside from that, you know, the map itself, this map is Approach Rate 7, and again, 2 of the players on each team will be using Hidden, so it's going to be very interesting to see if you can really control not only your reading and your cursor, but also your nerves. I think this is one of those maps that you can really get tripped up if you lose your focus.
And also, when you're spending so much energy just on reading, it can become really difficult to execute your aim and your tapping the way that you would expect.
Oh, yes, for sure. I think focus is going to be a really big issue for a lot of players playing this map.
This is one that I'm excited to watch people play.
Oh yeah, this map is definitely one of my favorites for sure.
It kind of goes hard. Just being real here.
Yep. You can really see, especially with the placement of the spinners in this map. They really...
What is the star rating for this map?
This map is a whopping 4.45 stars.
That's pretty close to 5.
You're gonna say
it's
that the whole
wet.
Tournament. Oh, now here we have the Pentagon. Now you might be thinking, that's pretty crazy. Now wait till you see this. Oh, that's right.
If I'm gonna be, you know, if I were one of the anchor hidden players on this team, I would be pretty nervous by this map.
Oh yeah, I would probably want to forfeit the whole tournament.
Yeah, if I was like there and playing the map, I saw the leaderboards come up during a break, I'd be like, oh wow, both teams are full comboing because, you know, Hippoka players, they don't miss. And then before I know it, I'm caught off guard. The Pentagon is here, the FBI, the CIA, and then, you know, I just have to hit the pattern. You know, it can get pretty scary if you just lose track of where you are.
Yeah, you might be surprised. You know, a lot of people might think that, you know, they're seeing this map and all the dense patterns. And to anyone who might be a little afraid of going in for this map, just rest assured that, you know, when you're in Hippo Cup, things are just a little different. You know, you're in that lobby and you just kind of stop missing. So it's a little crazy. Just mm-hmm. sort of keep that in mind.
Now that was an insane play.
Yes, definitely agreed. And thanks again, Tana, for making this replay for us. All right, guys. Any guesses to Hard Rock 1? Oh, we're gonna have a little bit of an intermission here, just to discuss the pool so far, and predictions for the rest of the map pool.
I believe it is Snow Halation. I'm locking in as that is my guess.
Well, I don't have any guesses in particular, but I want to comment on the Nomad map pool in that. You know, it's full of just a lot of really interesting maps. I think a couple of them seem to be pretty consistent, pretty comfortable for a lot of players just as a whole. But there's definitely a few of them, like this Nomad 7 and what was the, you know, there was another one.
Yeah.
That I would expect people to get tripped up on, especially the hidden players with the reading of this low AR and also the tech.
Yeah, I'm really excited about hidden being a thing in this Nomad, in the Nomad pool, because, you know, you don't often get to see these the Nomad 5s as a hidden or free mod pick. You know, you'll finally get some of these dense streams or some more crazy tech for hidden players mm-hmm. that they really need.
Right.
And I think you know, if you're coming from the perspective of, well, you might be one of the core hidden players that the team is counting on you to be able to you know, perform very well on hidden through some of these Nomad picks, especially this one. And the other one that stands out to me is, I believe it was the Nomad 4, the tech pick.
Oh, yes, yes.
Like, those two could be very difficult to read. I think those might be top contenders for bans, even if, like, a lot of the players just can't get comfortable with them. But also on that note, I think they could be really strong if you wind up being very comfortable on the very low AR hidden.
Yeah, I think a lot of group stage is sort of balanced around all players sort of being able to play at a relatively even skill level, but mm-hmm. still there's usually something in each map that is designed to trip up players that aren't quite as consistent to give a comfortable playing experience to everyone, but still let the stronger team come out on top. So yes, mm-hmm. thank you all for your analysis. And with that, let's see whose prediction was correct. Hard Rock 1 is going to be none other than Addiction.
Awesome.
Apraxia.
Yes, this is definitely one of the Apraxia maps.
Yeah,
it is patented.
Apraxia. And thank you, Meg, for getting this replay in for Hippo Cup.
Yes, definitely agreed. Meg is doing a really good job playing this map right now. Now, you see, if we turn off the interface of the replay, then it becomes very ambiguous as to whether or not this replay is actually recorded or if this is being done live at the moment. Because, you see, this could very well just be a spectated score that we're witnessing live right now. And we're really not sure how it's going to go, but any guesses? I mean, if I had to make a guess, I think if this player was participating in Hippo Cup, then I think it would make for a very different outcome than if they were not.
I think we might even see them SS if we're, you know, not, you know, already knowing the results and just predicting. I'm honestly praying for the SS.
Yeah, this replay is definitely really, really riveting. Now, here's something that I don't think many of you guys expected to happen here. We're about one third to this Mappool showcase and things are going to get a little crazy. So currently in the general channel, there are around 9 people just kind of hanging out there. And so we are going to how do I put this? Put people in some sticky situations where we're going to drag them into this channel and they can either stick with us or go back to their conversation. And see, the thing is, if they go back, then they won't be able to change their mind. So this is sort of a one-way ticket to joining the commentary booth. Now, you guys might think, oh, that's crazy. You can't just add people to the commentary booth. But see, watch what happens when I drag someone into the booth. Now, here we have Kali.
General Kali.
What?
Otherwise known as...
What am I doing here? I just wanted to talk in the other chat.
Okay, so here's the proposal. So you can join us in the commentary booth, or you can go back and talk to the others. But see, once you go back, then you can't change your mind.
Oh, okay. Okay, well, here's the thing. Can you hear my roommate in the background?
No, I cannot. Oh, yes, I can.
Okay. Maybe a little bit.
Yeah, maybe I shouldn't commentate.
Do they want to join us?
Yeah, do they want to join?
You mean the other chat or my roommate?
Your roommate.
No, your roommate.
He's playing Valorant. He's not gonna help out.
Oh, he could... Does he have any thoughts on this map?
He can pause.
Albert, do you want to commentate with Habib?
Yeah, I could.
You actually want to do this?
Commentate
Lee? No, like with Khabib.
Khabib?
Yes, a Mappool showcase.
What the? Oh no! How scuffed are the masks, bro?
What do you mean, how scuffed are the masks?
No, it's pretty good. Tell him it's pretty good.
Khabib mask. Okay, it's gonna be scuffed.
You want to talk to him?
Khabib, how scuffed is it?
You know, it's.
Get closer,
it's a Mappool.
Like out of a 7, how scuffed? Like 4?
Oh man, it's off the charts.
Okay. It's not even a 5 out of 7. It's like a 9 out of 7.
Like a 10.
Alright, don't tell Kevin. That's all I'm gonna say.
I don't know. I thought that map was pretty.
Why are you bringing Kevin into this? He's not even here right now.
Exactly.
Oh my god. Are you sure you want me to stay here?
No, you see, it's really up to you. It's really up to you. But. You know, once you go back, then you can't change your mind. So,
is it possible I can just tell? Like, is it possible I can just get someone else to join this? Like, take my place?
No, we'll have another round of this.
Yeah, we'll pick someone. We'll pick someone out for you.
Yeah.
Wait, what's the next map? Like, what map slot?
Hard Rock 2.
Oh wait, I'll watch this one actually.
Okay.
The Hard Rock.
All right. Yeah. So here but we
after
have.
After that, I'm a dip.
The second Hard Rock map.
Wait, there's a 6.5 version of this.
Amazing art.
Wait, he did this with Hidden. Oh, that's so
sad. Yes. Oh, okay.
Oh, like, why?
You can just go if you want.
Oh, God. Dude. You just ruined it. It's... Okay, man.
All right, man. I'm sorry.
I personally attacked right now. I don't know. Yeah, I think someone else should go in. I don't think this is a good idea.
Also, if I wasn't in a Valorant match,
it's fine. Don't worry. Okay. Yeah, you know what? Someone else should do this. I'm a little. The mood's gone. I'm sorry. Oh. I'm sorry.
Thanks for joining.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, thank you for your time.
Thanks for having me in here.
Okay.
All right. Well, I would like to thank the first person to beat the game, Zosima, for this replay. You know, he's really busy. You know, he's. He finished the Osu, you know, he's got other things going on, you know, he did the Osu Olympics, I don't know.
Yeah, he's a celebrity now.
Yeah.
So is there a reason that you chose to showcase the HDHR replay over just the HR replay?
In particular? You know, just to feel something.
Right. Well, it was awesome. Nice
for stuff. Some variety.
You know, usually when I play Hidden, I feel nothing.
I know what you were saying earlier. Like, I get a feel for what you were saying earlier about having the map pool be a lot based around control rather than general consistency. Because for a map like this, you need quite a bit of control in all aspects. Your aim, your reading, and your tapping. And if you can't delegate enough focus for each of those aspects, then that could really trip you up quite a bit in a map like this.
Oh yes, for sure. So this map is 128 BPM, and Hard Rock, you know, making it AR10. So the lower the BPM, the faster the AR feels, just because there's less notes on the screen. And also it being OD10 actually makes it pretty tricky to maintain accuracy. So I suspect a lot of teams playing this map are going to find an accuracy battle of some sort. I suspect a lot of B ranks to come out of this map.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and at 128 PBM, like, I consider like 140 to be like the lowest comfortable alt threshold. And at 128, you know, some players might not be really comfortable with alternating at the speed. You know, they're going to eat a lot of hundreds, you know, finger lock a ton. And, you know, the players who, like, are really comfortable with this will really shine on this map.
Mm-hmm. And I feel like for some players, the hidden might make it a little bit easier just to adjust to the AR itself.
Oh, yes, for sure. I think a lot of people say, you know, they're only comfortable on high AR if it's with hidden. So this is mm-hmm. really going to level the playing field for those players. So the third Hard Rock map out of four total. Now, this is going to be a very interesting pick. This is one of the picks in the Hard Rock pool. Now,
oh, man.
Thank you, Shikibe Mayu, for this replay. Just for Hippo Cup, actually. Really, really kind to make this replay. And we can see...
I think you could even say that they made this map for Hippo Cup.
Oh, truly, yeah. And you can see this map.
Maybe didn't know it yet.
It just kind of doesn't let up. This is one of those maps that, like... Now, you might think, you know, you have some room to breathe, but it just kind of keeps going. And, like, it's really going to require a lot of control from the players to maintain their combo and also hitting all these slider ends like you were talking about before. It's you know, especially in score v1, if everyone's going to be FCing, then it's really going to come down to those slider ends,
right? And I think with such a short map like this, any accuracy drop or any, you know, especially a slider break or miss, like that is just it's doomed,
right? That would be really bad. That would be really bad.
Oh man.
So joining us for the Hard Rock 4 is going to be TD. Thank you, TD, for making this replay for us. And this is definitely another map.
What? Habib, what is...
So this map is courtesy of none other than I'm a Fancy Lad for such clever design in the precision pick for this Hard Rock map pool. Now we have flip flap, flip flap. Now this map you might think is a little strange, you know? Precision, but not the way you might expect. This map is 117 BPM and it's got quite the circle size. So this map originally is CS7, and so coupled with Hard Rock, that does make it a grand total of 9.1 circles in size. And that's definitely a lot. So on top of that, this map is very interesting in its length. You know, there's a very polarizing dichotomy between the lengths of Hard Rock 3 and Hard Rock 4. See, the last map, we had a map under 1 minute, 45 seconds in total, and this map really takes it way in the other direction in a grand total of 5 minutes and 7 seconds.
What's the approach rate for this map, Habib? Did you already say that?
Well, I'm glad you asked. The original approach rate is 1.7, and I wish I could tell you that with Hard Rock, but I would have to quit out of the replay, so maybe someone else can check. But, you know, that's a very good point, because this map could also be coupled in as a low approach rate map, because a lot of people, you know, they see this map and it's pretty low. So a lot of people... Oh, yes. What's going on?
I just have to ask if you can tell us more about why you chose this map.
Oh, so you see, that's actually a great question. So in case you guys didn't know, I'm not actually the only person map pooling for this tournament. Now, I am map pooling along with none other than I'm a Fancy Lad. And we were just having a good time looking through our work for the week, you know, we're checking in. checking in on our weekly to-do list, you know, getting ready for our map pooling sprint, design sprint. And now, before I could really get into the groove of things, Mr. Fancy Lad, he made a very bold proposal, and he said, "Dude, flip flap, Hard Rock, the small CS." Now, you might think that I would be quick to reject that proposal as preposterous. But instead, sometimes you just have to take a risk. And when you see potential, I think you just have to follow your heart.
Yeah.
How
I
long
think...
is this map?
No, that's a great question. It is 5 minutes, and you guessed it, 7 seconds. Look at the spinner. Look at the spinner. Just really spinning.
I have not seen this player dip below 400. I'm sorry for tricks. Go on.
Yeah, this pick is definitely a good business decision for Hippo Cup. It's gained quite the attention, and I'm sure we'll see many, many people picking this map, whether it be during the ban phase or the pick phase. It will happen.
Right, this map is definitely going to be one of the more popular ones.
You know, I feel like at a high level, like a lot of these players are, if they can manage to FC a map like this, it could potentially come down to how fast they can spin like that.
Wow, a spinner battle on this map would be amazing.
I would love to see something like that.
Yeah, we rarely get to see that skill aspect of Osush ever come into play in matches, because usually it's done by combo or by accuracy. But when it does happen, spinner battles are so exciting.
Well, typically, if you're a pretty decent player who, you know, can't really spin all that well, it doesn't give you too much of an issue as long as you can clear them, right? But that might not be the case in a map like this. And with Scorvy 1, there's no slider axe, so as long as you hit these sliders, you hit them.
Yes, you do.
Unless you don't.
Well, I said as long as you hit them.
Right, but, you know, like, what if you don't?
I'm sure we do not need to consider that regard, considering...
That's not going to happen, because this is Hippo Cup.
Oh, spin!
Oh,
you're gonna you need to win the map. Spin. Yes.
Let's go.
Dude, people are gonna check the leaderboard at the end. That's definitely one of the picks. So, a bit of an intermission again, as we are around halfway through the map pool. We have finished the Nomad and Hardwork pool, so just a bit to discuss. You know, to see what we have so far. So, do you have any new considerations for the map pool as a whole?
Yeah, Hard Rock is one of the categories.
Thank you very much. That's quite the analysis. And with that, we're going
to
be moving...
I really want to see somebody pick this map.
This map?
I really want to see this map get played, yeah.
This map, yeah. Definitely.
That's all.
Definitely. This is definitely a map.
Yeah.
The... Double Time First is going to be this lovely, lovely map by Milo Milkshake. And now you might be thinking, that's not a mapper. And you would be right.
Thank you, Mr. Milkshake, for this Osu play.
It's definitely like looking at a whole different game after watching 5 minutes of that last map. I do have to be real.
And honestly, that Hard Rock 4 pick could be just used as just like a surprise pick shot, like, or, you know, make your opponent not completely ready to adapt to the next map, you know? Just use it as like a small slap in the face so you can win the next map.
Oh, of course. Right. It's definitely going to be a sort of mental reset of sorts, or even a mental destroyer for some teams.
Now, about a third of the way through this map just looks, just consistent. That's
Yes.
All that my impression is, really. What's the BPM of this map?
So this map is 195 BPM, so it's definitely on the friendlier side for Double Time. I think that's going to be the majority of the Double Time pool, as far as speed goes. There's nothing super high BPM, very intensive in this pool. So those of you who are not very comfortable with speed, you will... find this pool very friendly.
Mm-hmm.
And
you know,
also,
I noticed that jump section, but otherwise everything looks like it would on these sliders here, but other than that, everything looks pretty comfortable for the average, especially Hippo Cup player, of course.
Oh, yes, yes, of course. So this map is also AR8 with double time, making it AR9.67.
So it's almost just like a Nomad, but the song is fast.
Oh, yes, yes. That is one way to put it. However, you know, here at Hippo Cup, we are strong advocates for song choice, and with that in mind, I think any Mappool slot is an opportunity to put a song. So here in the Mappooling team, we really try to use that to our advantage.
Mm-hmm.
Excellent philosophy of mapping. I will write that down for my next tournament.
Be sure to have a song there. You know, the background's pretty cute too.
Yeah, very, very nice. Simplistic. Very wholesome.
Mm-hmm. Although, I do think, looking at a bit more of this map, it could be kind of tricky to act some of these slider ends. And yes. Some of the tapping patterns. Like at parts where it slows down, like just there at the end.
Right, the gaps in rhythm.
A little bit difficult to adjust to, so I could definitely see this becoming an act battle pretty easily.
Yeah, I think a lot of people might mess up on like the reverse sliders that have like kind of go back a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, they do.
Yes, they do. So now I think we've made it pretty far into this Mappool showcase. I think time to spice things up a little bit again. What do you guys think? So let's give another person in the general voice channel an opportunity to join us. Now they will be able to make the decision.
Can I vote for Sayo, who's about me, says I'm a homie to all?
That is quite the proposal. So
you can reject it. I don't care.
Here's what we can do. Here's what we can do. We can do a best of three to see if people join or not. I think we got to amp things up a little bit. Last time was a best of one, so let's get Sayo for a seat. See what's going on here.
Hey.
Hello. Good morning, Sayo.
Good morning. It's nice little 11 p.m.
Oh yeah, same here.
Oh yeah, me too.
Oh, that was hard.
So here's the proposal. You can either join us for the rest of the showcase, or you can go back to the general channel. Which one will you choose? But if you go back, you cannot change your mind.
I guess I'm here all night then.
Oh my god.
Let's go.
All right,
hey,
guys.
I told you, Habib.
That was quite the proposal, Mushi. Now, let's see. Who is going to be the next person to join us? Now, I have quite the suspicion that there's someone in this general channel that is going to make for a very interesting case here in the staff commentary booth.
Hey.
Oh, hello. Hello, Kay.
Kay?
Welcome to the booth.
So
we played together yesterday.
Oh my god, you're a big fan.
Oh my gosh. Wow, thanks.
Big fan.
All right, so back to business, guys. I think Kay, welcome to the commentary booth. Now I have a bit of a verification for you to make. Would you like to stay in this channel and join us for the rest of the showcase?
I would love to stay in this channel, Habib.
Okay, but you can't change your mind.
Okay.
You cannot leave.
Are you sure?
Okay. Yes, I'm 100% sure. I unfortunately made the horrible decision of taking a 5-hour energy drink thing.
Oh dear.
Yeah. It tastes like battery acid, but I did a lot of homework.
That's awesome.
That's awesome. Now back to Osu. Thanks for the intermission, guys. Now here we have the second double time featuring RLSC, one of the players in the game, and Now see, what do you guys think about this map? Just give me your honest thoughts.
I think this is one of the maps in the game. It does have the double time modification with an optional hidden. There are notes on the screen. There's a lot of doubles and triples. Some stranger aim.
Now,
yeah,
you
I'm
see
that this could actually become an axe struggle here with some of these finger control patterns.
You know, I beg to differ. I don't think there's enough act battle. You know, this guy's SSing, so clearly it's too easy.
It might actually come down to the spinner.
I think, isn't there a funny pattern in this? Maybe not.
I'm seeing a couple patterns.
It's a silly little pattern.
It's a nice little entry-level tapping map. Beautiful choice. Yeah, that little pattern can trip some people up.
I love the song choices. I think all of the song choices are absolute 10 out of 10s.
That's what I was thinking. I was thinking whoever pulled this is just picking straight bangers. Nothing else.
I have an interesting observation about this map, and this sort of piggybacks off of what Vertarik said. So I think, if I'm not mistaken, and of course correct me if I'm wrong, but you did mention that there are some notes in this map that we can see on the screen, but I'm noticing something very interesting, which is that I'm not really seeing them. So, like, I'm, you know, can you tell me a little bit about that?
That's a strange contradiction. Well, you see, I have no object permanence, and
I'm so sorry.
I'm
okay. We're gonna move on. So this is double time three, guys.
Wow, this has notes.
This one definitely has got some notes in it. And this map, 225 BPM, mapped by... That's right, you guessed it. Ignore this. So, you know, interpret that as you will, but I think we definitely gotta check this map out. This map also being AR8, it is 225 BPM. That is faster than Freedom Dive.
That is faster
than Freedom Dive. So, does that make this the fastest map in the pool so far?
Yes, that is correct. Keen observation.
Fastest map in
It is not the fastest map, but it is one of the fastest. It is the fastest so far. Oh, we got that slider, wave slider.
Man, ahead of his time.
That slider is a work of art. I don't know what to say. Truly a genius.
Yeah, it's a lot of. The aim in this map is really compact, so you know players need to be careful not to over aim. And maybe even not to under-aim as they try to read these patterns and move their cursor to them.
I think some of these sliders might be actually pretty easy to trip up on as well, and that would be very detrimental in a map as short as this.
How long was that?
Oh, great question. That was 1 minute and 6 seconds. But, you know, we're going to be amping it up a bit in the next map.
You'll miss it.
Just a bit.
Now... this next replay comes from someone very, very special and dear to all of our hearts. This is someone who has been around for a very long time and really been a beacon of positivity to the OC community as a whole with his positive affirmations all over the internet. And that's right, Shield. Thank you, Shield, for making this replay for us.
Well, my better half.
Yay, Shield.
You know, as much as I respect the hidden, I wish he did not pick hidden for this, so we can fully appreciate the approach circles of the map.
What is the approach rate for this map?
What approach circles?
Oh, great question. So this map is actually approach rate 9, so you might be wondering, oh my goodness, AR 10.3 in a group stage map pool. But do not fear, this map is quite simple, and also, I believe if you have an AR 8 hidden, in a map pool in 2022, then there should also be a 10.3.
This is kind of scary, to be honest. I feel like with every circle that pops up, it's a bit of a jump scare.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah,
I'd just be not the player for this map.
I'd be quaking in my boots.
Oh, shiver me timbers.
Miles at the end of a map. I'd be very nervous to play this map.
Oh man, Wordle, guys. Okay, oh shoot. All right, no time
for
Wordle.
How long is this map, Habib?
Oh well, you see, that map was definitely a step above the previous one. So DT3, we had 1 minute and 6 seconds, and this one clocks in at a total of 1 minute and 8 seconds. So we're really making strides to improve the total length of these maps.
Mm-hmm.
And
such an amazing SS from Shield. Truly a display of skill.
Yes, can we get a thumbs up for Shield and his wonderful double S? Now, joining us for the fifth double time. That's right. There's 5 out of 5. And that wow. is, it is significant. This map is significant. This map is just extremely significant.
Poison.
I love this background. It is so abstract.
Oh, yes. Can we get background dim staying up on this map?
Yes. Oh, that is, those are some of the circles across the screen.
So this map really goes across the screen. It,
wow.
It really just goes around. Like, you really have no idea where it's going to be next.
Yeah, players are going to be tested on their geometric aim.
I feel like if, you know, more on a more serious note, if you're sight reading a map like this, you're going to struggle quite a bit. Unless you just happen to be comfortable with something like this.
I would dare say it's almost a crime not to play with, you know, 80% background dim for this map.
Oh, yeah, at least.
Funny you should say that, because I'm really good at this specific map slot, which is the Chinese map. This is all I play, so.
Well, that's
luckily, I have the BGM.
0% background dim, yes?
Absolutely.
Oh, what a trooper.
Someone in chat is requesting the BPM, and that would be 140.
Yeah, and something interesting to note, that if you have your background dim down a bit, you'll see the super cool guy and the super cool, nice lady in the background. You'll be empowered by them to play this map, play it to the best of your ability. So I do recommend turning down that background dim so you can see the beautiful background.
Yeah, they're really there to cheer you on and really provide a positive affirmation.
And you just don't get that if you have 100% dim.
You really miss out on the experience.
I don't know if you could see that, but that mountain range back there?
Oh, yes.
Kind of closeted and covered by those clouds, but that break gives you some time to take a look at it.
I see it, and for our viewers, when you see it, you can tell us in the chat too when you see the mountain range.
Oh, I see it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
it's beautiful.
For sure. It really gives you something to strive for, you know, having long-term goals.
Like seeing that in a break in a tournament like this, where you're so pressured to FC, and any little mistake, any act drop or slider end miss or anything is really detrimental to your whole team's score. Just, you know, taking a break to observe the background mountain range could be, you know, kind of what you need to quell your nerves a little bit.
True. I definitely find some peace of mind after seeing this background.
Yeah, see that really nasty square pattern, and that square pattern means absolutely nothing to the vastness of the mountain range.
All right, that is going to wrap up the double time pool, and that brings us to only 4 maps left. There are 3 free mods and then 1 tiebreaker. Now,
I love free mod. Please explain the free mod rules, Mr.
Yes. Unlike me, some players might not have read the forum post. And,
the forum post.
I might
post.
Need a refresher on the free mod rules.
So, you might think that since for the rest of the map pool, 2 players need to play hidden, that you might think that the same thing applies to the free mod pool. But in fact, it is called free mod for a reason. And so the free mod pool is going to work just like any other tournament, where you need a minimum of 2 players to use either hidden or hard rock. And that is all you really need. So if you have no mod, hidden, that is okay. If you have no mod, hard rock, that is also okay. And you could have all 4 players go hidden or all 4 go hard rock, etc. You could have 4 players go hidden hard rock. And just to showcase this map in particular, we are going to be using an interesting mod. Now you might be thinking, this map is just like any other map in the pool, because he's using hidden. And now, you see, you might be right, and you might be thinking the free mod pool is just going to end up being an extension of the no mod pool, because if it can just be no mod, hidden, then that's just like anything else, right? And you would be correct. However, there will definitely be some maps.
I'm actually a big fan of this map.
I will.
I like maps.
Me too. But this map in particular, I'm actually a really big fan of. It's quite a lot of fun to tap, in my own opinion. So I'm excited to see it in the map pool, actually.
Yeah, it's also really fun to listen to. Like, occasionally, you know, in tournament matches, I would, like, you know, I try to calm my brain down, you know, stop playing so I can listen to the enjoyable song.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Just, like, the sounds that it's got.
I think I might change the background on this to the last maps. And play with zero background them.
You know, that would be awesome.
I think that's the secret here.
I think the move is that you just must be continuously inspired by... the woman and the man in the previous map's background, you know? Great, great moral support.
You think they're dating?
Never, never assume.
I think they're married.
You know?
That was awesome.
That was a great map.
Alright, so...
choice.
An interesting gimmick of this tournament map pool showcase is that for the next map, I believe it would be significantly appropriate to have some of the viewers join us in aiding in the replay submission. So what we are going to do is for the next map, I'm going to link the map in chat, and if someone has a modded replay, be it hidden or hard rock or hidden hard rock, then you may send the replay file and I will play it for everyone to see. Now, while the replays are coming in, let's try to see... if anyone else would like to join us in this
app
channel.
Ignore the fact that I'm playing the map right now as we speak.
Oh, is that so?
Wait, I own the Osu Beat map. Hold up.
I do not think.
All right, this is not indicative of Hippo Cup players. I'm so sorry. Here, let's find this message, Hippo.
As much as I would love to play it hidden hard rock, I do not have the skill required.
No, I wouldn't be subjecting our poor viewers to disappearing circles once again.
Now, here we have a lovely replay from Vertarix. Thank you very much for joining us in making this replay specifically for Hippo Cup.
Yeah, that, no problem,
man. That's very, very friendly. So we are going to get started here. And as you can see...
Hi, Jacob 3.
So while this replay is loading in, getting started, let's find someone to potentially join the commentary booth for the rest of the showcase. Now, any proposals for who we should drag in here?
I'm a huge fan of bringing in Psycho OK1.
Oh, yeah. Okay. OK1.
I love that idea. Hello, Psycho. Welcome.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey.
So, we have an important question. So, you know, we're watching this Mappool showcase. It's going great so far, and we were just kind of wondering if you would like to join us.
Okay, so I was just helping Venprist with like a calculus question. And apparently I've forgotten math after half a year. So I think I'll just stick here, I suppose.
Oh, I see.
How do you live when you forget math? What do you do?
I don't know. Oh, I don't know, hard. Man. It's pretty hard, you know, going to the grocery store not knowing integrals.
Like it's tough. Like,
what do you do in your free time?
I don't know.
It's not math homework.
Long walks on the beach. Or...
imagine going to the bank without the intention of doing derivatives. I'm quite disappointed, Zika.
I'm so sorry, Kay. Okay, anyways, stop talking about the,
Oh, Osu!
This is kind of depressing, isn't it? Alright, so what's this map about, Habib?
Ah, right. So I'm very glad you asked. Now, see, drawing our attention to the replay, we can see the lovely display of hitting all of the circles, and you might be wondering, what exactly are these circles? And now, see, I'm glad you asked. They are... not only on the screen, but they are also disappearing from the screen. That is quite an interesting gimmick.
Can you explain that phenomenon right now, Habib?
Right, so you see, they call it Schrodinger's circle. The circles are both on the screen and not on the screen at the same time. Until you click them. And that is the very interesting gimmick of this map. And something else about this map, actually. So the song is... definitely there, but also there's a map.
But there also isn't a map.
So my impression of this is this map is that it's pretty consistent. I mean, I could have just not been paying attention at all, but it looks fairly consistent in its testing of each skill of the reading, the tapping, and the aim altogether.
Yeah, this map is approach rate 9 as well, so being in free mod, mm-hmm. we might see some hard rock players playing hard rock.
This looks like a fun map.
Man, this
it
map.
It does look fun. It looks like a Nomad 3 to me.
It does look like a lot like a Nomad 3, but with hidden modification.
Oh, so V2. All right. Well, we asked, why am I playing Score V2? Or sorry, V2. So V2 stands for the OSU version. I was actually playing on OSU version 2.
Oh, I see.
And, you know, that kind of changes. Like, trust me. So I know the score looks weird, but if you, you know, multiply it by 10, add 3, and then you, you know, take the derivative of that, you know, you'll get the score V1 calculation. You know,
oh, I see.
It really
that's
sucks
why.
For people who damn forgot it. How to do math. Yeah.
Quite
yeah,
unfortunate yeah. if you don't know how to do math.
Now you gotta rub it into me. Okay.
I would if only Bartek was here. I believe he is a math major.
Oh. Yeah, that's oh, wow. right. Bartek is a math major.
He can play OSU.
He definitely knows. You know when like people watch you play OSU and they don't know what's happening and they're like, dude, how do you know which number to press on the keyboard? How do you do it so fast? Because a lot of people are like, yeah. whatever number is in the circle, you have to press that on the keyboard.
You do, right?
Yeah, you do.
Wait, so what about circles that have the number 96 on them?
Oh, you press both at the same time.
96, yeah.
Yeah, it also has this interesting
aspect.
So it's like playing 10 key mania with aim.
105.
Well, you press all three of them. See, that's the thing. Sometimes you really, there's this intricate strategy with OSU where you take your hand off of your aiming peripheral just to press the keys. Sometimes you have to use both of your hands because sometimes the numbers become like four digits.
Thank you for enlightening
right.
me.
Well, right. other players have the strat where their hands are just big enough.
That's true. Yeah. Some people really, really stretch out their fingers and they kind of go crazy. I mean, you have five mm-hmm. fingers to work with. That's definitely a lot.
You know, there's some OSU players who have a background in Guitar Hero. So they take some of these strats, kind of like this one guy. So they basically hold control their mouse with their elbow or their pen in the crook of their arm.
Oh.
And they use that to aim while they use their hands to press the keys at the same time.
That's very interesting.
That is some strats right there. Now you're telling me stuff. Holy shit.
A live play of that, to be honest.
Yeah, this game has been out for, you know, maybe 15 years or so. And, you know, throughout the years, we've seen a lot of different strategies. I know a couple of people have used their feet to control the aim and then just had all 10 fingers available to press the numbers.
You know, I don't know anybody who's done that, though.
It's been explored.
Think about it. The foot is a third available appendage. Why not use it?
I have two.
Wait, yeah, you only have one foot?
Oh dear. Is it like what? In the middle or like
what?
Can we get going to be
so
I'm sure you want to talk about this or
I mean I think this is worth exploring, Kay, if you have any insight on what's going on here. I mean, if you don't want to talk about it, I have no idea if it's personal and, you know, we're on stream.
I have two legs, don't worry. I was just...
But okay. Not two feet?
If you're right-handed in OSU, wouldn't you be right-footed?
I think... I mean, I'm pretty ambidextrous with my feet. So here we have the third free mod map. This map really, really is a wild ride. This is a blast
in
the past.
Yes.
Oh my god.
I love this.
Oh my god, how did you know I love this map, Habib?
Oh yeah, you know, anything to make you guys feel better. I know that conversation got a little crazy, so I thought I would lighten the mood.
The song does make me happy.
How can you feel sad when listening to this music?
I know, right?
Can you guarantee a Grant Kirkhope song in every pool?
No.
Man.
Can you guarantee at least one Frums map in this tournament?
Oh, well, I'm glad you asked. And actually, yes, it appeared in the group stage map pool. So the very first one. A very grand appearance.
Thank you, Habib.
I feel blessed right now.
I feel insanely blessed.
This is awesome.
This map really makes me feel like I'm at home.
A burst of joy when they play this map.
I hope so too. As they should be.
I really hope every match goes to tiebreaker so that the players can experience all of the maps available to them and have a great time.
Oh yes, Habib. Please explain how many maps there are needed to win in Grand Finals.
Oh, in the Grand Finals map pool. Yes. I'm very glad you asked. So in the Grand Finals stage, very interesting to Hippo Cup, there is going to be a best of 15. Now you might be wondering, that's crazy. No one ever does that. Now, you would be right. But, you know, just for fun.
So that would be first to 8.
Yes, that's correct. It's first to 8.
Yeah, we have a lot of maps.
Yeah, so maps. potentially like, I don't know, how much would that be? I can't do derivatives. Yeah.
Unlike
would that be 15 maps played?
Yes.
For the group stage, though, is what's the best of?
Oh, it is best of 9 in group stage. So first to 5 points, and that means up to 9 maps. And if you do play 9 maps, then the 9th map is going to be this very special map that we picked out to be the very last one. And that's right. Anyone want to read out the wonderful name of this map?
Uta. Oh, yes. P8107.
That's right. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now, this map... you know... It's got, like... You know...
It's got circles.
Oh, that's a yep. That wiggle pattern.
If you know, you know.
But you know, I mean, it's Onoken's banger. I like Onoken.
You know, I do think that this is like kind of you know, a manifestation, an example of what you mean by having control as a main theme throughout the map pool. Because this isn't like other tiebreakers that I've personally played in practices. This is very kind of techie and control in both aim and tapping. So.
Oh, agreed. And reading, to be honest, there's like really strange accelerating patterns at some parts of this map, especially towards the end. But yes, that is a good point.
Yeah, that might prove difficult for some of the hidden players who are forced onto this.
Oh, true. Right. Look at that stream. Look at that stream.
There are also hidden players in this one.
And how long is it?
Is a perfect display of skill. You know, it really tests a player's ability to adapt to a pattern.
This map is 6 minutes and 0 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
It is also 6 stars and 0 millistars.
Oh.
You know, something I didn't get to mention earlier about free mod is that you can take more mods. You can take more mods than your opponent. You have a mod advantage. Now, this is a seldom talked about feature of free mod where teams can actually get a score advantage without even having to do anything special. They just click a button in the menu and boom, you can get more score for free.
Mm-hmm.
That's crazy.
What's the catch?
They should do that.
It's so crazy how mods give you more score in matches. Amazing.
Yes,
with no drawbacks
to gain an edge over their opponent in the match.
Think about if you take Hearth Rock on a map, you get to play with a higher AR. So crazy.
The more the better.
The more the better. The bigger the number, the better. You know, it's like money, right?
But wait, I thought that was like golf.
You know, you do.
It's golf. Because you have a tablet pin, which is the club.
Let me pull up his profile.
Ball, which is a circle.
You do really have to keep in mind here that this is hardcore a combo game. Like, this is still score v1, so the longer that any of these players can hold their combo, that's just going to be the entire game, really.
That's
and on
true.
A map like this, it's hard to imagine, and you know, everybody FCing.
Right, but definitely,
but
I think
it's World Cup players.
If you look at the numbers, you know, if you look at the team that has more mods, they have more multipliers. So, you know, in here in Osu, I think typically people refer to that as a mod advantage, where you have a higher score multiplier, meaning that if all players were to not miss and maintain similar accuracy, then I think the team with the mod advantage would come out on top, almost by default.
But, you know, the mod advantage is, you know, still very difficult to maintain just because it's so much easier to break on a mod, especially like Hard Rock, where the OD, I'm not sure what the OD would be with Hard Rock, but that would just make it all that more difficult to act and even combo.
Yeah, actually, if you have a mod advantage, the opponent can also turn on their mods as well, and you no longer have that advantage.
Oh dear.
You can have a mod disadvantage.
You do make a good point.
That's true. It really just comes down to who's better at that point.
Yeah, I didn't realize that your opponent could do it too.
Crazy.
It's something to take into consideration.
Yeah, you do have to keep in mind your opponent can do whatever you can do as well. If not more sometimes.
I think there's a very interesting strategy with having mod advantage, which is that if you have mod advantage, then that actually provides some intimidation to the other team to really make up for that difference by out-comping you. And I think that can put a lot of pressure on those players to know that you guys have the combo advantage or the mod advantage.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it'd be like, you know, like standing a little taller, you know, spreading your feet apart, you know, bigger.
If everybody goes hidden Hard Rock on Tiebreaker, then nobody has a mod advantage.
Now you see, that is true. Now, does nobody have the mod advantage, or do both teams have the mod advantage?
Does everybody?
That is the question.
Everyone has mod neutral.
Okay,
not gonna lie, those double cuts, whatever Hansen doubles, they look terrible on Hard Rock.
Nonsense.
So Habib, this might be a silly question, but I am curious. Are players allowed to take easy in a map like this?
Now, that is a great question, and I actually don't remember if we changed that rule.
Okay, as a referee for the tournament, I can confirm that there was no easy.
Okay, yeah, that's what I thought. Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah, you knew that all along. You just wanted to test K's, you know, information.
Yeah, I'm just testing my staff members.
Yeah.
Oh yes, of course.
Spin the win, guys.
Give it a round of applause.
Let's go.
Wow.
Amazing SS. Quite amazing.
Lovely.
That is the end of the map pool, isn't it? Unless there's a second tiebreaker.
Oh, no. That is the end of the map pool. Thank you all for joining us.
Oh,
and
that was awesome.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah, so now you guys might be wondering, just watching this map pool showcase, but where are the matches? You know, when is this happening? And that's
Please
a great question. So those of you joining through the Twitch directory, if you're not following this tournament, the group stage matches are going to be this coming weekend and also next weekend. So we have the weekend of the 19th and the weekend of the 26th. There are going to be group stage matches streamed a lot, I hope. Maybe anyone want to stream these matches? Let me know. Yep.
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 Well, you know, those are some pools that you... that you pulled for this tournament.
Oh, definitely, yeah. And to everyone who watched the Mappool showcase, thanks for watching.
Thanks.
Thank you.
I have a question regarding mod advantage. Have you guys ever like sort of done a trade offer, or it's like you take Hidden Hard Rock and then the other opponent takes Hidden Hard Rock? When neither of you were planning to?
Happened. Yeah, there's this one time in a 2v2 tournament, we were like, hey, everyone go Hidden Hard Rock. And we were like, sure. And we went Hidden Hard Rock.
Wow.
Wonderful story.
I will not disclose the results of that map.
What were the results?
I have personally not seen a mod advantage trade, but I have seen a map advantage trade in my time as a referee, yes.
Oh, what did that look like?
I had witnessed a player discuss a gentleman's agreement about not banning a certain Nomad 5 against a prominent speed player, this player proceeds to then pick Nomad 5.
Oh dear.
He and then had lost.
Oh my.
Oh my. Mm-hmm. Oh my lord.
Oh dear.
That is what we call
actually the mod trading in free mod. I feel like it's more common with the easy mod rather than the hidden or the hard mod. I feel.
Oh, that's true.
As far as I'm concerned, like I go easy, you go easy. All right, boom. You know,
that's true.
Yeah, and it usually only happens between players who are somewhat familiar and know that they're either equal in skill or better. Slightly better at the specific mod they're trying to trade.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Or it's more fun if both of you are really bad at it. And then you have no idea what happens.
Yeah, that can happen too. I mean, yeah. That is fun.
You know, I think it would be quite amazing if players had the freedom to take the mod Flashlight on tiebreakers.
Oh, I think that would be awesome.
I think that'd be
great. I think that would make everything just a lot more enjoyable for everybody involved, to be honest.
Mm. You know, I think limit testing OSU tournament players is truly one of the feats of our time.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, very well said.
I have to agree with you there.
Mm-hmm. All right, with that, thank you all for joining us for the Mappool Showcase. Now, there's one last question that I would like to ask you all. Is who are we rating?
So a wholesome OSU player.
Can we rate Chizuka-nyan? She's very wholesome.
She is extremely wholesome. I can't.
Let's rate Esther.
Can we get user page?
Esther is quite wholesome.
Oh, username paste in the chat.
There you go.
Thank you all for joining us. Be sure to join the tournament Discord server if you have not already. Stay in touch with announcements and join us this coming weekend for the first round of group stage matches. Thanks to everyone for commentating and for watching, and we will see you all next weekend.